Good morning, everyone. Here's a tiny talk on a practical motto for living well. Cultivate a mind of respect and awe. From the Wan teachings, the founding master addressed the congregation. Today, I will tell you the most important method of guarding the mind and protecting the body. So listen carefully and use it always as a motto for practice in all sensory conditions. The motto is, never neglect a mind of respect and awe. This means that whenever and wherever you encounter persons or things, treat them always with a mind of respect and awe. Let's define awe as an overwhelming feeling of reverence, admiration, surprise, and wonder, often inspired by the majestic, transcendent, or sublime. We are advised to guard our mind from unpleasant states by embodying a spirit of respect and awe at all times to everyone and every interaction. Then are we supposed to be continuously awestruck by the great majesty of everyone and every situation, even when they're annoying? I don't think so. That's not practical, and I don't think that's what the founding master had in mind. I suggest that a mind state of respect and awe is the natural outcome of our awareness and experience of being part of this cosmos, this existence, this continuum of experience in all its stunning brilliance. This is a perspective of non-duality. Our mental framework rests on the facts and patterns of the physical universe. But most of the time we lose contact with awe because we are completely occupied with activities and thoughts of daily life. This is a perspective of duality. This mental framework rests on the same facts and patterns of the physical universe, but is further complicated by the inherent arbitrariness of the human enterprise. So how do we cultivate and maintain a mind of respect and awe? For me, it's through knowing the cosmos, by spending time in nature, and learning astronomy, cosmology, and physics through podcasts and videos. I like to zoom out beyond the headlines and the drama and see the Earth as the pale blue dot suspended in space. Science and Buddhism share these two fundamental questions. What are we dealing with here? What's the big picture? It feels natural to me to inquire about where we live and how it works. The mind-boggling space and time scales of our universe are an endless and delightful puzzle that force me to expand my mind to simultaneously comprehend vast complexity and sublime order. My mind stretches to hold so many things together at once that they coalesce into just one thing, one universe with me a part of it. I can usually connect with awe when I tap into that concept. I have to do this daily to maintain respect and awe, and I fail frequently, but that's why they call it practice. The founding master goes on to say, if we live righteously by maintaining respect and awe toward all things, then whether we look at the blue sky above or the wide earth below, all things created throughout the entire universe will be for my use, and all laws practiced in this world will be mechanisms for my protection. You may have already encountered today's themes in the epigrams in the front pages of the Red Book. Everywhere a Buddha image, everywhere a Buddha offering, and timeless Zen and placeless Zen. I seek to cultivate a mind of respect and awe, and understanding the cosmos is my inspiration. This creates harmony, and when I encounter fellow beings and situations, I hope we gently smile in the shared knowledge of our grand adventure together. Thank you.